20s. He lived like 33 or something years old, 36, I don't know. Not long. He wasn't sane. We know that. He died of a venereal disease. We know that too. And we also know that these all get important. We also know that he was not only an excellent organist, but he was an incredible violinist. He was actually perhaps a better violinist than he was organist. And we also know that he was famous, he got in trouble with the church authorities, I forget where he played, for playing the violin, which he did incredibly well, apparently, and accompanying himself while playing the violin with his feet. Now, at first I thought this thing is not possible, but in fact, it is possible. And so today, I found a piece by Bruhns. He didn't write it, so it wasn't hard to find. I found a piece by Bruhns, and I did a little forensic work, and I looked at it and realized the organ part was really simple, but the violin part was really complicated. And so therefore, I think it might be the piece that he got in trouble for. I'm not sure about this. I'm not as good a violinist as Bruhns by any means, but I'm going to give it a shot, and you'll see if you hate it or not. I'm going to play it just to make things even more interesting. I'm going to play it on this object. You're wondering, what is this object? This object is an electric fiddle. The reason I'm using an electric fiddle is because my actual classical violin is in this shop, having the carburetor fixed or whatever they fix on violins. So I'm going to play it on this thing rather than play it on nothing. So we'll try it. This is a separate little piece part, but it's only going to play like, I don't know, 5 measures of it. But you'll give you a sense of the thing I think you got in trouble for playing. We'll find out. If you don't like it, it's not on the program, so you can say you never heard it. There. Now I gotta get a little compliment here, just like he would have done. That ought to do it. We'll see. Okay.